Okay, don't fall, please. I just said don't fall, but you did.
Bitter. Coffee for two.
Hello everyone, Bunny Coffee here, and this week I have a figure to unbox. This is a character from Dragonscrown, which is just called the Sorceress. Even in Japanese, it's Sorceress. It's a 1/7 scale painted figure, so no building on this one. It's a fully painted figure. And all the detail. This is actually a new sculpt. There is an older figure, which I also have. I'm going to show you one. So Dragonscrown is an adventure. It's like an RPG beat-em-up hybrid. To the core, it's a beat-em-up. You are given a mission and you kill a bunch of enemies. You progress in side-scrolling levels and you can choose up to... You can choose six characters, so this one, she's one of the characters from there. And these characters, you can also level them up. You can level up their skills and choose what kind of builds to make. It's a really fun game. I played it over and over again. Even to this day, even if after years of its release, I still play it from time to time. It's a really fun game. So this figure is from OrchidSeed. Obviously an Atlus Sega IP. Let me show you the older figure to compare it. There are actually multiple renditions of the Sorceress's figure from different companies, but the one I liked the best before this new box is the Megahouse version. As you can see here, where she holds the frog and she has her staff over here. And you can actually take off the hat, and this is actually the color that I choose when I play as her, when I play her character. And look at the detail here. It really looks like the Sorceress that you incarnate in the video game itself. So I really love this figure. And now we have the newer figure, which is made by OrchidSeed. Which is also aesthetically pleasing, as well. I like the addition of the. So, if you don't know, in fact, the Sorceress, she can revive some dead bones. So, if you see a pile of bones, so some adventurer died in that dungeon, you can actually raise it as a skeleton minion, as you can see over here, and to fight for you. So, let's check it out. Nice. Yeah, I really like also how they include a really large box to protect the figure. So if you're like me, I like taking photos of my figures, and especially the ones I paint. And you actually have this backdrop, which has the Dragonscrown logo. That's pretty cool. See? Always check some tapes. They always put a lot of tape on the sides. Okay, this is the model. Wow, she's beautiful. Just look at her face. It's so well detailed. It's just perfect. The color over here. This is more the standard stuff that you would get during your travels in the video game, in the Dragonscrown video game. Pretty common, but depending on the properties, always change. It's a random ability, random attack power, and durability changes as well. So let's take a look at the sorceress herself. Wow. Oh, so it's only one block. But wow. She's just beautiful. And I love the soft transitions. So it's well airbrushed. There's a bit of warm tones over here. Her chest, obviously. And highlights over here, which gives the illusion of the velvety material of her robes. And I love her hair. Okay, don't fall, please. I just said don't fall, but you did. Anyway, here's the handsome guy. So there is actually a peg here in which you, I guess you put her right foot. So it's stable when you put this on any shelf. Remember to wrap the head around her hands and near her bosom before pegging the feet. Okay, I think I got the left foot correctly. Now to insist on the right foot. She's got some awesome spells and she can glide. She can levitate. I mean, it's just awesome. You can see here, it says dragonscrown sorceress. Kind of hard to see. Oh, there it is. Yeah. These are the two models. So this on the left is from Megahouse, and the one on the right is the new version from OrchidSeed. You can see from some of the details that there are some differences, like with her. What should we call this?
Forearm.
No, her
sleeve.
Sleeve. Yeah, well, with her sleeves over here, they seem to be more detailed in the Megahouse version. You could see on her sleeve that there is a bit more detail when you see the blues. There is a slight blue color that provides more contrast with the black. The OrchidSeed version is just plain black. See, no variations. Except for this one, but there's not a lot of contrast. Also, one more difference I saw was the hat. So this is the Megahouse version, which is more bluish, and this is the purple version. In fact, in the game, you could actually change their color scheme. So this is just purely aesthetic. The staff too. So the staff here is just less detailed. It's just a normal staff that you usually get when you go adventuring. While when you see the Megahouse version, it's a more elaborate staff. Oops. More elaborate staff with a design. The colors in the OrchidSeed version is better. They're softer. The transitions to the purple, from purple to pinks, are smoother. Compared to the Megahouse version, which is a bit patchy. It seems that the sleeve and the corset is more well detailed, but less on the robes, on the skirt itself, while here it's the reverse. The hair seems to be it's darker in the OrchidSeed version, it's darker, while on the Megahouse version it's more transparent, semi-transparent. It's a different expression, so I don't really prefer one over the other, because I like it here. She's more like in a wicked mood, and here she's just more determined, or like a teasing look more over here. You can see that for the Megahouse version, there is actually a cobblestone tile, which is great. It really symbolizes the town's in dragonscrown when you play the game. And here it's a more just transparent one. I really prefer this style over this, but this one could actually look good on a glass cabinet, I'd say. The hat is actually magnetized, so you see it snaps into place, and You will have no fear turning the model upside down. So that was the Sorceress figure from OrchidSeed. Really great detail, and I also love the magnetized hat. This one's so cool because the other version, as you can see here, doesn't have that magnetized hat, and sometimes when I clean them just keeps on falling off. So thank you again for watching. I hope you enjoyed this unboxing. If you have any questions, feel free to put them in the comments below. And please don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you next week.